Sentinels, and welcome to SCTV Episode 3. We've got a delightful show planned for you today.
I'm Daniel Gonzalez.
And I'm Paul Ryan.
Today, we prepared a cornucopia of content for you guys. We have two segments that will really knock your socks off.
And some Seton stories you'll definitely want to hear.
From PSATs to Kairos to Beautifully Rooted.
This episode is going to be more real than the socks you just had to put back on because we knocked them off already.
Speaking of real, let's get our first segment going.
Here's Seton Catholic's very own Lucas Long Garcia. Let's hear what he has to say.
Thanks, Daniel. Follow me and we'll learn about teacher fantasy football. Back to you, Lucas. Therese, how has fantasy football affected your ability to teach theology class?
It is an extra burden, that's for sure. But I actually put my faith in God and say, Lord, just help me to choose the right team, right players this week. Give me your wisdom, give me your grace, and it always works out. This season, I'm actually undefeated, the only undefeated staff member left. 3-0, no one else can say that. So yeah, I have not lost yet. Yeah, well, currently looking at the spreadsheet here, Miss Belinsky is winless, as well as Mrs. Hunter. They are both winless. Maybe it's because they're Bills fans and not Packers fans, I don't know. But whatever the reason, I truly wish the best for both of them. Absolutely, yeah. Even if I take an L here and there, it really won't affect the overall score. I was the winner last year. I will be the winner again this year. And that's just the way that things are going to go.
Now I'm here with
Mrs. Hunter.
And
Mr. Leach.
So today we continue our journey talking about fantasy football this year. Mrs. Hunter, how's the season going?
Why don't you ask Mr. Leach that question first?
What do you think, Mr. Leach?
Well, you know, Lucas, we're going into the end of week 4 right now. I'm on a 2-1 streak. Didn't do very well last week, but this week I'm poised to defeat my opponent, and I'm feeling pretty good about my team right now.
That's good to hear.
Yeah.
Lucas, why don't you ask Mr. Leach why he didn't do particularly well this week?
Why is that, Mr. Leach?
Well, last week I didn't do well because my players didn't play very well. That's typically how it works.
Was there anything you were hinting at, Mrs. Hunter?
Yeah, I would like you to ask Mr. Leach why he is also using Ms. Virus's fantasy league and trading between the two leagues.
Here's the deal, okay? Ms. Virus, lovely, lovely teacher, has not yet made her account for fantasy football. I was given manager power over her team until she gets her account, and she hasn't done it yet. So I thought, you know, if I have two teams, I can use both teams to my advantage, and I don't really see a problem with that. If I pay for Ms. Virus's team, then
it's cheating.
That does sound like cheating to me, sir.
What's cheating about?
Anyway, Lucas, to answer your question, I am 0-4 this season, but I'm okay with that because I'm doing it honestly.
That's very respectable.
Okay. I have not been dishonest about anything. Everything's been forthcoming. Everyone knows what I've been doing. It's not like I've been lying about it.
No, you've been open about cheating. You've been open about trading amongst two teams, which you're not allowed to do.
I'm sorry, you're not allowed to trade?
Not amongst a team that you established. You loaded both teams with incredible players.
I didn't load. Okay, Ms. Virus auto-drafted.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't even pick the players on her team.
May I jump in?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you ever run these trades by Mrs. Virus?
Okay, it was only once, and no.
That sounds like cheating to me.
Good question, Lucas.
You heard it here, folks. Thank you very much, guys. It's been a pleasure.
Mm-hmm.
Can we shake hands real quick?
Hold on.
All right. Thanks, guys.
I really loved hearing from them. Our teachers are such interesting and cool characters.
I agree. They are absolutely wonderful.
I've got to say, I think I totally could have crushed their fantasy league. It looked so easy, a toddler could have won.
Quit being so glib.
what?
The defaced lanyard of Ollie has just been found in the photography room.
Tuesday, October 1st. The Fine Arts Building halls are crowded before sixth period, even with the rain. Hidden in the chaos is the element, waiting to strike like snakes. And I'm there too, watching. 2 years of classes have turned me into a nocturnal animal. I must choose my targets carefully. It's a big campus. I can't be everywhere. But they don't know where I am. We have a signal now for when I'm needed. When that bell rings in the quad, it's not just a call, it's a warning to them. Fear is a tool. They think I'm hiding in the shadows, but I am the shadows.
Where were you? Tuesday, October 1st, where were you?
Class, I was in class.
What happened in Mr. Menace's classroom?
It's actually Thursday on October 31st.
Thursday, October 31st was the movie.
I don't have Menace.
We're talking about Tuesday.
I don't have Menace.
Where were you?
I'm a junior. I have nearly...
What happened to Allie's lanyard?
What are you talking about?
What happened to Allie's lanyard?
Don't know.
Tuesday, October 1st, Mr. Menace's classroom, where were you?
I was with you, Paul. Wait, that's Paul.
No.
Yeah, you don't have the eyeliner on.
No, I'm Batman.
No, you're Paul.
No, that's someone else.
I can see without the eyeliner. Yeah, I was with you doing the SCTV
episode. You might be mistaken, but I understand a lot of people, it happens to everybody and it's okay.
No, you are Paul. And I was with you. You know I'm innocent.
No.
Yeah?
No, because I'm Batman.
No. Okay.
I'm Batman. The photography room. Allie's lanyard, where were you?
Why so serious, Batman?
Why so serious? The lanyard is an integral part of the Seton uniform. It tells the story of who you are. It tells the teachers where you're from. It says your name, your grade. Say that again.
Why so serious, Batman?
Joker!